This is an important chord.
Basically, I'm talking about here, I've been feeling this world cycle, and I've been feeling it for the past hour and a half, and now I want to talk about, talk about what I'm feeling. Because I'm seeing the world. Kitty, stop. Excuse me, the cat's here. I'm recording, I'm doing my work right now. I'll open the door in a minute, kitties, alright? I'm trying to concentrate on my work. Anyway, sorry about that. Anyway, I was saying that I was seeing that there's a world in which beings on their world from the time they're born until the time they're age 13, all they're taught is spiritual things, true spirituality. There's no schools in which they talk about, like schools on earth do, about like what do you want to be when you grow up, what kind of work do you want to do. That's what, do you see what's happening on earth? The kids are taught from a very young age, like, what do you want to be when you grow up? And you want to be a fireman or a judge or a police officer? You want to be a farmer? The kids are taught stuff like that. So, and the world is almost trying to program kids to think that what they have to be when they grow up is a work. From the time kids are young in this world, they're taught in schools to believe that they have to work. That the only choice they have in this world is to have jobs and make money and not to do what they love to do. Think about it for a minute. From the time kids are young, they have coloring books that have pictures of jobs and they color pictures of factories and stuff like that and workers and stuff like that. And those kids are just seeing that on our world that, all the adults are talking about is work. Work this, work that. From the time kids are babies, all they're being shown is work, 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 work. That's all they're being shown in this world. It's like, what do you want to be when you grow up? You've got to go to college so you can make a lot of money. You've got to get good grades. You got to get to a good school, otherwise you won't get a good job. You got to have the right school in order to get to the right law firm. You've got to have the right grades to get to the right med school. It's a constant competition on this world for a mental program, and that's all the school is. Think about it. That's all any school is a school of mental programming. That's real important to always remember. Any school is nothing except a place of mentally programming other beings. That's all any school is. Is a place where beings are trying to make other beings believe a certain way by doing certain things. Through coloring books that depict nothing but people working and jobs and stuff like that. Through classes that talk about boring things all day that lose kids' interest. That's another failure in this world. They've forgotten how much more can be done when the kids are truly enjoying learning. When you teach them stuff that's fun instead of the same old boring old math, the same old English and term papers, the same old science lessons. No, you don't do that. You teach them something fun. It doesn't matter what it is. The point is that you're teaching them. It doesn't matter what you're teaching them. The point is that you should always keep teaching the children as they grow, in any way you can. And it doesn't have to be a traditional way. That's what I'm trying to say. It doesn't have to be in school or anywhere else. And the children are all of us. When I say the children, I say teach one another, no matter how old you are. As we grow young and into new lives, as we die and become non-physical, and then pick a new body to inhabit, and then inhabit that body, and then become non-physical again at death, and just, you know, going through those cycles as an eternal being, that all of us, yes, we all are eternal beings. Don't ever forget that. Some people out there actually don't believe that we won't live forever. You know, that's just their illusion. That's just their illusion of life. That's all it is. That's just their illusion of living. All I try to do is make somebody happy. All I try to do is represent love in a way that treats a person with kindness and respect, and ways of understanding one another that teach each other to respect one another. That's the common thread that happens in other worlds. The common thread of life and other planets is that they've learned to respect one another. It's not that their technology is advanced. It's not always there. But it's that they've learned that each being is worthy of respect and of love, no matter what they do. They recognize the importance of each being, because each person is celebrated for their contribution of their mind. Let me jump back to that for a minute. On this society, this cell, this alien world, and this world, I've seen that all the inhabitants wear these gray outfits, these dark gray outfits, and they're, the tallest ones are only about 5'9" and 5'10". And I'm seeing a ceremony that, it's a ceremony of graduation, basically. You know, they've reached age 13 and they've had 13 years of spiritual training. They don't have traditional schools where math and English and all of that's forced into them. They just have fun lessons about life and living, and about what it takes to be positive and to be happy in this world. Or whatever, you know, that's what it's taught to those particular beings on that world. You know, for 13 years, nothing but that. You know, nothing but having fun. For 13 years, you know, they programmed spiritual lessons in terms of fun. Those beings have fun. They teach the children to have fun, and they have fun with the children for 13 years. But at 13 years, those children turn into adults when they step into that machine. At 13 years old, after that spiritual training, that's when the technical side of their society is put into them. You know, it's only after 13 years of constant spiritual lessons that they're deemed worthy enough to handle the knowledge of their society. So the knowledge of the society is given to them through memory implants. They step into in front of this thing. It looks like it's the size of a face mask. And it comes down on a lever from the ceiling and fits over their face like little sucker, like electrodes, like you see on something that stick on the wall, with little suckers that stick to the wall with air. It looks like that. And it sticks on your face, kind of, and it's basically the memories of other people are taken like this. At age 13, their brains are implanted, you know, into a crystal. A copy is made of their physical brain's output, the brain waves, and stored on a memory crystal. And that crystal goes into a library that's much like the Library of Congress, for example, in this country. You know, it's just a huge collection of nothing but memory implants at age of people at age 13. And each person's life is an open book. Those crystals are public knowledge. Anyone can go there and take a crystal and insert it into a playback device. You have to go there to do it, but you know, they have those repositories everywhere. You know, there's copies everywhere in their world where you can go and put these headphone-like devices on and go into another person's mind using the copies on those crystals. And you go through those person's spiritual experiences during those 13 years. And then you take the best parts of them. You sit there and you go through their lives as if you were them. You're sitting there playing back their memories in your own mind using an extraterrestrial device. You're playing back their memories into your own physical brain. And it's just as if you were them physically. It's just as real as right here, right now. Everything around you physically, it feels just as real as that. And time can be the same way too. Time can be just the way it is here. You know, it feels real, and it's so real that you know, it's almost unbelievable. You know the power of this device. And on that world, you know, safeguards are built to the device so the person doesn't get lost forever in a memory playback, you know, because you can set the device, you know, to play back for long periods of time through different memories. You can take different experiences of a person's life, the different months of a certain year, for example. You can scan through the days of their lives and pick out different memories. It looks just like a VCR. I see it now. It's just like I'm living it right now. You take the device and you scan forward, scan back, you know, just like, you know, you do it a fast forward or rewind on the DVD, for example, you know, and you do it. But instead of movies, you're seeing days of a person's life. You know, you're seeing them waking up, you're seeing them sitting there in class at 9:30 a.m. in math class, and what they're thinking about. You're looking at their actual experience in that moment. You know, and you fast forward, you mentally fast forward to, for example, you can skip forward 3 months to their birthday and at 8 a.m. And you can skip forward to a time, you know, for example, you see them wake up and then they're in the shower, and then you skip forward to them at the bus, for example, they're at the bus stop, you know, ready to go to school, you know, or, you know, you rewind if you want to see a scene again from their life. You know, this kind of mentally, it's mental. This is such an advanced extraterrestrial device. It's so amazing. And it's so easy to build, and that's what I see. I see a lot of technical specifications psychically. I don't just see these things. I realize that how to build them. That building them is not out of our reach in this world. Absolutely not. Some of this stuff we can really do, we can recreate and really experience with Earth-based materials. All it takes is the knowledge of what materials, and getting that knowledge is easier than you think. You know, it's common knowledge of the universe, this type of stuff. You know, the knowledge is out there, and it's there for us too. You know, on this world, this is the memories have been programmed. You know, they've made it so you don't have to go to school constantly to learn something. If you want to become a doctor, you can program a device with all the memories from various doctors' lives, all the technical memories, and program their memories into your mind, accessible at any time. If you need technical details, you can just scan them with your physical mind. They've been implanted in your brain. The thoughts are basically implants spliced into your own network of neurons using a particular form of light. It's a type of non-physical light that penetrates the tissue in your brain. And it's actually built to penetrate your skull and go into your brain non-physically without any cuts, anything like that. You know, it's a form of non-physical light. Just like radio waves, for example, or cell phone waves, go straight through your brain. this device uses a type of energy that will go straight through. I mean, I'm so brave, but I meant the skull. I was thinking more of the skull. You think that the skull would stop certain things, but some radio waves, cell waves penetrate your skull and go right to your brain. And energy also heads out of your physical skull. Not physical energy created by the chemical reactions your brain does. The neurotransmitters within a human's brain stem, for example, control breathing and locomotion, things like that. All that stuff is controlled with chemical reactions and brain tissue. That's all it is. But playing it back is something else entirely. I'm seeing that memory playback is for real. And this is the movie I want to talk about. This is a good idea. Now, don't tell anybody else this. You know, this is, I don't want anyone else to know about this yet,